regreso aquí en Auto 060. Estamos aquí, vamos en California. Bueno, nosotros estamos aquí en el estudio en Miami, pero vamos a ir hasta California y vamos a cambiar al inglés otra vez. We're here in Miami, but we're talking now to NK from Mazda in California. How are you, Dean?
Very good. Very good.
Thank you. You're in one of my favorite places in the world, Laguna Seca in Monterey, in California. How are things there today?
Well, it's typical for Monterey. It's a little foggy in the morning, but by 10 o'clock or so, it'll be spectacular at the track.
Exactly, and especially at the track, like the famous Laguna Seca track, which Mazda has had a relationship there for a long time, right?
The track has actually been named Mazda Raceway for the last 12 years since the partnership began between Mazda and the county. The track is owned by the county of Monterey.
Yeah, I know that. I've been there a few times, and it's really spectacular, and it can be pretty tricky if you don't know what you're doing, right? Especially in the
corkscrew is the famous turn.
Yeah, I was there once at an event for another manufacturer, and it was a pretty expensive car. It has a lot of carbon fiber parts on it and spoilers and all that, and we heard a lot of braking, and then like boom, 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 boom. From the pit area, so you can imagine what was going on over there. But anyway, it's a really fun place to be. But we have Dean out here with us because Mazda is also involved in something else. I mean, like driving fun and fast at Laguna Seca is one of the main things with Mazda. But also Mazda is involved in the Project Yellow Light. Can you tell us a little bit about this, please?
Well, what we try to do is connect the dots on several things. Mazda has more young race drivers than any other brand. We, in between our various series, Mazda-powered U.S. Formula 2000 Championship, MX5 Cup, Pro Mazda, and all these. We have a bunch of teenage race drivers from around the country and around the world, for that matter.
Yeah.
A lot of drivers from Canada, Mexico, and elsewhere. We knew that distracted driving was a huge problem among the youth, and so we tried to kind of team up and raise awareness because we have these young ambassadors. The teenagers may not want to listen to you or I tell them to not drive distracted.
Yeah.
But if it's one of their peers, they're more willing to do it. So we teamed up with the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, aka NHTSA, which is part of the Department of Transportation, and a small nonprofit called Project Yellow Light. And what we're doing is we're awarding scholarships to high school seniors and college students for creating 60-second public service announcement videos on the dangers of distracted driving. We just announced our winners. We have six students from around the country who are getting some scholarship money from Mazda for their efforts in helping raise awareness of these dangers.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. So those videos were made by the students? I mean, no big production or anything like that? Just like...
No, they're very, very simple, and you know, it's astounding. I mean, if you've been to an Apple store, you can find kids under 10 years old learning how to edit videos. So it's not...
Don't make me feel bad, okay? Because I did some video myself, but yeah, you're right. It's amazing that technology today.
So, the results are very impressive, and we're happy to be associated with it. Because, one, we like to do some give back to the community, and we try to do it in ways that are kind of relevant to our products and things. So we do that on the youth safety side.
Yeah, and you were saying Mazda is very driven to young drivers, being associated with Laguna Seca, the video games actually is one of the main things that starts the kids in getting interested in cars, right? And the Miata, I believe, is one of the most driven cars for weekends and tracks, right? I believe that's true.
Yes, Spec Miata is the number one most popular race car for road racing in the entire U.S. by far.
Yeah.
There's almost 3,000 of them. And the fact that Mazda sold over 900,000 Miatas since 1990. Actually 1989 when they first went on sale there. We're approaching our 25th anniversary, so there's just a ton of those cars out there, so they're very affordable if you want to go racing.
Yeah, and the ratio between power and weight of the car and all those characteristics make it really fun to drive.
But you nailed it there. I mean, it's power to weight ratio. It's not the Miata, the MX-5 Miata is not a high power car, but the power to weight ratio is excellent.
Yeah. So this project, was this the first time that Mazda was involved in this?
Yes, It's the second year for Project Yellow Light, and the first year for Mazda to be a partner with us.
Yeah. And for our audience, you mentioned that there's all the videos. Is there any website or any place where we can just Google it, but is there a webpage for
Project Yellow, ProjectYellowLight.com. You can go on there. You can also find there's a Project Yellow Light page on Facebook.
Yeah.
And I said your listeners can find it either place. And hopefully, you know, everything works. And I see this as a multi-year project for us, we hope. And we hope to give a lot of money away to young adults in high school and college.
Yeah, it's really it's an amazing project, and it's also very important because, as we all know, I mean, there are states like here in Florida where we don't have any laws against it. They just passed one law, but it's really lame because it's like a secondary infraction. So you have to be something. You must have done something wrong before. And texting at the same time, which happens, but still, it's not very good.
Yeah.
So it's a very good campaign to make people aware of what can happen in those situations. What's going on in Laguna Seca these days there with Mazda?
Well, right now this weekend I'm out here for the American Le Mans Series along with the SECA Pro Racing Playboy Mazda MX-5 Cup, Cooper Tires, Prototype Lights, and a few other races out here. So this is the kickoff race weekend for 2013. Later this year, we'll have MotoGP, World Superbike, of course, Monterey Motorsports Reunion, the biggest vintage race weekend in the country.
Yeah, can you tell me a little bit about that? That's in August, right?
Yeah, August. Yeah, every August, you know, the whole area of Monterey becomes just a mecca for, you know, vintage cars, because there's the Monterey Motorsports Reunion at Mazda Raceway. There's also the Pebble Beach Concours. There's Concours Italiano. There's a bunch of the vintage car auctions. It's really kind of the biggest gathering for vintage car buffs in the country. It went from one weekend to now it's about a week and a half.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, the love of cars that people have over there, and like, but everybody from around the country go there to see these. But the Mazda specifically has something going on there that week too, right?
Well, I mean, since it's our home track, I mean, we always have there's Mazda content no matter what. And the Motorsports Reunion, Mazda usually pulls out several of the cars from we call it the museum. It's really our basement at research and development, but we keep several of the vintage Mazda race cars. So we'll be running several of the infamous four-rotors.
Yeah.
The GTP car, one of the Le Mans 787s will run, the championship-winning Mazda RX-7 GTO car. And those are, if you've never heard a four-rotor, they scream.
Yeah. That's great. So Laguna Seca, it's a very fun track for me. When I was a little kid, my father used to send us from Mexico to summer school in San Francisco, and my cousin used to sneak me in the trunk of his car to get me into the track to see motorcycle races that he loved back then. So I always have good memories from Laguna Seca there.
Well, it's kind of funny. This track is very unique from the standpoint of this was a U.S. Army base when the track was originally built in the 50s.
Yeah.
And when the base was closed down, they turned it over to the county of Monterey. So it's technically the Laguna Seca Recreational Area is a Monterey County park. Within is Mazda Raceway.
Yeah.
And so the track is actually, the official name for the track now is Mazda Raceway.
Yeah.
And everything they do there is a charity. It's a non-profit. And any profit they make are invested back in local charities in the Monterey County area.
Yeah, that's great. So, well, thank you very much for your time, Dean. Is there a webpage for the actual track where people can also look at all the activities that Mazda is doing there?
Well, I mean, you can go to MazdaRaceway.com. You can also go to MazdaUSA.com and look for the tab for motorsport. For those of your listeners who are on Facebook, we have a Mazda Speed Motorsports Facebook page that we update multiple times during any race weekend, so you can kind of go behind the scenes with us at the track.
Excellent. We'll do that, and we'll post all that information on our own Facebook page so people can have access to it.
And we'll like your Facebook page.
Thank you very much, Dean. And likewise. So thank you very much. Enjoy the weekend there with Mazda, and we'll also keep telling people about this Yellow Light project that Mazda is involved with. Thank you very much for your time again.
Thank you for having us on the show.
Excellent. Pues ahí tiene el proyecto Yellow Light Project en el que Mazda está involucrado para Alertar y llamar la atención de los jóvenes, principalmente, ya que Mazda es una marca orientada en algunos aspectos a los conductores más jóvenes con autos como el Mazda Miata, que es el, como decíamos ahí con Dean, uno de los autos que más se conduce en pistas durante los fines de semana acá en Estados Unidos. Casi 1 millón de Mazdas vendidos desde que debutó acá en Estados Unidos, y un auto súper popular para los que les gusta hacer el tuning. Pero bueno, ahí tienen el Project Yellow Light. Pueden ir ahí, projectyellowlight.com. Vamos, como dije, está la información en nuestra página de Facebook, facebook.com/auto060. Y ahí tienen una iniciativa muy interesante, un proyecto para publicar videos que llamaran la atención sobre el tema. Muy impactante a la vez, porque lamentablemente hay chicos que han muerto a consecuencia de esto. Así que pongan mucha atención en este tema, involúcrense en él, y quizá pueden participar también el año próximo, como dijo Dean Case ahí de la Mazda. Él también, ellos van a estar involucrados en este proyecto durante de mucho tiempo. Así que información valiosa, divertida, interesante, y ojalá que muy útil para poder evitar accidentes y más muertes en las carreteras por el mal hábito que tenemos de manejar y enviar mensajes de texto al mismo tiempo. No se vayan, esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota, ya regresamos.